Hello dear students, today we are going to study chapter 2 of mathematics, which is fractions. Now children, you are already aware about fractions. A fraction is a number which can be written in the form of a upon b, where a and b are natural numbers. Children, a represents numerator and b represents denominator. That means a number which is written above the line is called as the numerator, and the number which is written below the line is called the denominator, and together it is called a fraction, a part of a whole. Now talking about types of fraction, we have like and unlike fractions. Children, fractions that have same denominator, such as 2 upon 9, 7 upon 9, 5 upon 9 are like fractions. Here in all these three example, 9 is there in the denominator. So 9 is same. So they are called as like fraction. Whereas those with different denominators are called unlike fraction, such as 1 upon 2, 3 upon 5, 5 upon 8. All these are having different denominators, so they are called as unlike fractions. The another type of fraction is called as proper fraction. A fraction in which the numerator is smaller than the denominator. It is called as a proper fraction. For example, 2 upon 7, 5 upon 8, 12 upon 17 are the example of proper fraction. And always remember that value of proper fraction is always less than 1. Okay, now the next type of fraction is the improper fraction. A fraction in which the numerator is greater than the denominator. For an example, 7 upon 2, 8 upon 5, 17 upon 12 are all examples of improper fraction. And the value of an improper fraction is always more than 1. Talking about the next type of fraction is the mixed fraction. A fraction that consists of a whole number part and a fractional part. That means it is a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. Is called as mixed fraction, children. Here few examples are discussed with you. It is 3 1 upon 2, 1 3 upon 5. Similarly, you can take any other example. Okay, children, we can also write fraction in its simplest form. Now, what do you understand by the simplest form? If numerator and denominator doesn't have any other common factor other than 1, we call that fraction as a simplest form of a fraction. For example, 3 upon 5, children. Now 3 and 5 comes in their own table and not in any other table. So the factor, common factor between 3 and 5 is only 1. So 3 upon 5 is in its simplest form. To find out the equivalent fraction of any given fraction, we multiply or divide the given fraction by a common number in the numerator as well as in the denominator. If I want to find out the equivalent fraction of 3 upon 5, simply I am going to multiply 3 by 2 and 5 by 2. I will get 6 upon 10, which is my equivalent fraction of 3 upon 5. Children, in your class 6, you have already studied about how to add and how to subtract fractions. Yes, talking about unlike fractions addition, we first need to find out the LCM of the denominator to make the denominator similar. So over here, I have first example as 5 upon 7 plus 3 upon 8. As you can see, 7 and 8 both are different. So first I am going to take out the LCM of 7 and 8, which is 56. Now I want to make 7 as 56 and 8 as 56. For that I am going to multiply the numerator also with the same number which I am multiplying in the denominator. So I get 5 8s are 40 and 3 7s are 21. Now children, both the denominators are 56. So now I can add these numbers. 40 plus 21 will give me 61. 61 upon 56 is a improper fraction. Yes, correct, because numerator is greater than denominator over here. So we are going to write down this number in a mixed fraction, and you very well know how to write down this in mixed fraction. This we have already started in class 6th. So you will get 15 upon 56 as your answer. In a similar manner, children, you are going to solve the other three questions also. The subtraction, the only difference is in subtraction you are going to subtract, and in addition you are going to add. But while doing addition and subtraction, remember you always have to take out the LCM if the denominators are not same. Okay children, now let's see few questions from our exercise, as we have already started about how to multiply a fraction with a whole number and a fraction with another fraction. Yes, you are correct. We are going to find out by finding the product of numerator and product of denominator. Now, this is the exercise 2A, first question. 2 upon 6 into 54. Now children, in this question, we will see that whether we are able to cancel the number which is present in numerator as well as in the denominator. So, we know in the table of 6, 54 comes 9 times. So, we can easily cancel it. It will be 6 ones are 6, 6 nines are 54. So, 2 nines are will give me 18. Similarly, in the next part, 8 ones are 8, 8 fives are 40. And when you multiply 7 by 5, you will get the answer 35. Now we are coming to the next part, which is a fraction multiplication with a fraction. To find the answer for this, we are going to find the product of the numerator. Now over here the numerator is 3 and 1. So 3 ones are 3 and 4 twos are 8. Next question, we'll check if we can cancel something in the crisscross or in the numerator denominator. So over here 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9. Then we are going to find out the product of numerator, which is 8 twos are 16 and 3 nines are 3 sevens are 21. In the similar manner, we are going to do rest of the questions, children. Let's see this G part. 12 upon 25 into 10 upon 18. Now, I can cancel 12 and 18 by the table of 6. 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18. Similarly, 10 and 25 can be cancelled by table of 5. 5 twos are 10, 5 fives are 25. Now, only I have to do is I have to find out the product of numerator and the product of denominator. So, over here, 2 twos are will give me 4 and 5 threes are will give me 15. So, my answer is 4 upon 15. So, I hope you understood, children. Likewise, we are going to do all the questions which are given on page number 28. Exercise 2A. I'm sharing the written part also with you. You can cross check your answers. Thank you. Take care. Stay safe.